What's going on, everyone? Today we're going to be installing a Gator ETX soft roll-up tonneau cover on the 2019 Ram. I'll post this in the video description, a link to it, as well as for the quad cabs and maybe a couple different options too, depending on your price range, if you want to purchase yours online. And if you're watching this thinking that it doesn't look like it's brand new, that's because it's not. I actually got it in July, spur of the moment, to throw on before I went to a rock festival. And I didn't have time to make the video, so I took it back off. We're going to show how to put it on. Depending on what kind you get, steps will be a little different. But for the Gator ETX soft roll-up, these are going to be exact steps for you, whether it's the quad cab or the crew cab, short or long bed. You're just going to have different length rails and tarp, but the steps will be the same. Sorry for all the junk in the bed, but just ignore that. First, what we want to do is identify the driver side and passenger side rails. So this is the driver side one. It has the lever on it. Passenger side has the hook, but no lever. So you'll want obviously both of these plastic anchors to be towards the tailgate. This is how they're gonna go on. Now, of course, that's for the Gator, like I'm saying. So if you have a different brand, you can use this as kind of a guideline, but you're gonna have slightly different steps. So you'll want to make sure you have six of these clamps. If you have this kit, there's three per side, and you'll need a half inch socket for these nuts. All right, so I'm just gonna show you how this is gonna rest in here. This is the passenger side one. The way I had it was I just kind of lined it up so that this top edge, not the actual adhesive, which by the way, this isn't actually like Velcro, it's more of like a lock strip, which I think is good because I feel like that'll be better in like snow and ice and it won't wear out, but time will tell. So this edge flush with the top of the bed rail, as close to flush as you can get, something like that is how I did it. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put either one clamp in the middle, or I'll put just the back and the front clamp on just loosely to kind of hold it in place. And then what I'm actually gonna do is shut the tailgate, because on the front and back of the rails, there's these weather strips. And I noticed when I had this installed previously that when you looked at the truck from the side, the tailgate stuck out about an eighth inch more than it should have. It wasn't fully, like it was latched, but it was forced out a bit because of these rails. So I'm going to shut the tailgate before I tighten the clamps so that everything is as mashed forward as it can be and is as tight as can be. Here we are on the inside of the bed. We're gonna take one of the clamps, see the little teeth on it, and we're gonna put it up here. You want the teeth to be in the grooves on the tonneau cover rail, and then the back side of the clamp should come around and grab back of the lip of the bed rail. Might have to loosen them up a bit and then push them up higher. Then you'll just kind of cinch it down with the half inch. I'll actually have to turn this around so we can get to the nut. Duh. There we go. I'm gonna cinch this down and then we're gonna shut the tailgate. There we are, just have the one kind of tightened down a little bit. Gonna move on and do the same to this side, then shut the tailgate. Sticks out a little bit, not as bad. But you can see, it could always go in a little more. All right, now you're gonna take your roll-up cover and you'll see the Velcro, or whatever you wanna call it, facing up. That is actually how you want it. You don't wanna take and bolt it down just like this. The studs right here, they go down into these holes, but it doesn't go like this, because you'll see this would be facing the wrong direction. The way it actually works is you flip it around and then you flip this down once, so it doubles itself up basically, and then now you can see the seal. Make sure to tuck these down so you can actually use them. And now we will line up these bolts into the front holes here.
the plane. All right, so we have the studs down through the holes. Now before you tighten these up or anything like that, we need to put in, if you have, sorry for the focus here, if you got this same tonneau cover, we have to put in our adjustment bricks, and I'll explain that in a second. So if you got this tonneau cover, you'll get two of these, one for each side, and they'll have numbers on them, and you can see that they're offset. Depending on which way you rotate or flip this, it's going to give you a different tauntness with the tonneau cover. The way it worked best for me, and it could be different for everyone, is I had it so, what is this, number one down here, was facing down and towards the front of the truck. So I've put it down into this slot, all the way, make sure it's in there, and then you take our little provided R key, and you'll slip it through the hole like that. Now we're going to take and do the same thing on the other side. Again, make sure that you're matching the numbers. So I'll want the number one to be facing down and forward again. They could be different though, remember. Got to kind of wiggle it to push it down. As you can see, it's not, there we go, it's getting there. Now it's fully seated. Get in there. Now we'll take one of these supplied plastic washers, put that on the stud that was poking through the rail here, and put this nut on there, and then just cinch it down with a 9/16 socket. And then you're gonna wanna roll the cover back and latch it into place and see how tight it is. You know, if it's too tight, you'll probably have to switch it around to a different number. And if it's too loose, same thing, but the other way. I can't remember, like 1 through 4, which one is the most aggressive, unfortunately. I don't have the directions anymore, but you got a 1 in 4 shot. So whenever you change them, just make sure you change both sides to the same number. Correction on this nut, it's actually a 14 millimeter, but you can use a 9/16. It'll just be a little bit loose. So I highly recommend using the 14 just so you don't round it out. All right, so still on the number one setting. Gonna roll it down. Now, don't try to hook it right here. That's not where it goes. It has to be up in here, this piece. Okay, now, and also, if it's way too tight, some of the Velcro may have grabbed, so what I recommend doing is lifting it up like that, give it a ripple all the way up to the front while you're pulling towards you. Then, put it in the little nook down till it clicks. If it's really, really hard to do that, you're gonna want to rotate your bricks around, switch the number. And if you do this and it's just way too loose, same thing. I'm gonna go ahead and try the tailgate now. Make sure it shuts. The seal, you know, it's as good as it's gonna get. Tonneau cover is not gonna keep all the water out. This still sticks out a little bit. And because I'm a little OCD, I think I might, because there's a double seal here, I think I might flip this one up and actually just trim with a razor blade this bottom and this top seal. They stick out slightly more than the center one. I think I'm just going to trim the top and the bottom off. And that should help with my issue that I'm having, but this was $215 from Amazon Prime, so I got it in a day. I have no complaints with it so far. Just one note, if it's a big deal to you, just like plastic loops with little J hooks on the straps. They're not actual clips. I've not had a problem with them. They haven't come undone or anything, but if you have to have a clip, you'll want to pick a different cover. So the last thing, you can see some lines going front to back. We're just going to want to kind of pull it a little bit. Do the same on the other side. This video helped you out, make sure you hit that like button, hit the bell, and subscribe for more videos like this, and check me out on Facebook at Tony Trekka. Thanks for watching.